For a long time now, Jimmy had been experiencing many sore throats. The doctor said it was due to his tonsils and they needed to come out. Being sick so often made Jimmy feel terrible. He missed a lot of school. "Pretty soon you'll go to Royal University Hospital for an operation," Jimmy's mom told him. "A doctor will take those tonsils out." Jimmy said, "I can't wait because I hate missing school and being sick." But then, on the day he was really going to the hospital, something seemed wrong. In the car, Jimmy felt all hollow and shaky inside. "I don't know what it's going to be like," he thought. "What if Mom can't come to see me? What if I have to get needles?" When they first arrived at the hospital, Jimmy, Bear, and his mom had to go to admitting. Here, the clerk asked for information about Jimmy, which was entered into a computer. After that was done, the clerk gave Jimmy a bracelet that had some of that information on it. He had to wear it while he was in hospital. After being admitted to the hospital, Jimmy went down to the mall area to get a blood test. "Aw, Mom, I hate needles," Jimmy said. He squeezed his mom's hand. "I'll be as quick as I can," the lab technician said after she had Jimmy and Bear sit down. After rolling up his sleeve, she wiped his arm with an alcohol swab and asked him, "Please turn your head and say ouch." Jimmy turned away. "Ouch!" he cried, but it was over in a moment. "Good boy," the lab technician smiled. "You did very well." Then Jimmy, Bear, and his mom went upstairs to the children's ward. He liked the bright colored walls and all the pictures. Jimmy put on his striped PJs that they had for him in the room where he was going to be staying. Then the nurse explained he was going to do a few simple tests. The nurse took his temperature, checked his blood pressure. Next, the nurse prepared an IV, which is a machine that keeps fluids going into your body, which Jimmy needed for his surgery the next day. After Jimmy and Bear were settled, it was time for supper. Jimmy had to eat now, as he couldn't have anything before his surgery the next day. After supper, a new roommate showed up. Ben had come to the hospital that day after he had fallen off his bike and broke his leg. Ben explained that after he fell, his sister called the ambulance. The ambulance and paramedics brought Ben to the emergency at the hospital. The paramedics were really nice. They put ice on his leg to keep it from swelling more. He too had to have an IV, and they placed a tube that lay under his nose to help him breathe. His sister was allowed to come with him, so he wasn't alone until his parents could come and meet him there. Once they arrived at the hospital, Ben was taken inside. The paramedics explained to the nurse what had happened and how they had helped so far. The doctor came, and he also checked Ben to make sure that he had not hurt anything else in his fall. The doctor wanted x-rays of his broken leg to be done. In the x-ray room, the technician helped Ben onto the table and took some pictures of his leg. Because it was badly broken, he had to have a cast and stay in the hospital for one night. Ben said to Jimmy, "Would you like to play together?" Jimmy asked, "With what?" Ben explained that on the unit there was a room with lots of things to do. He wheeled out of the room and returned with some books and games. Later, they went down to the playroom where Ben had borrowed the books and games from. Ben told Jimmy and Bear that this is a room just for children in the hospital. It was the best room. Toys, books, air hockey, computers, movies, papers, and craft supplies everywhere. The pictures that other boys and girls had made were on the wall, and there was a large TV for movies or for playing video games. There was a volunteer in the room that helped with all the stuff, and she organized some of the painting supplies for Ben, Jimmy, and Bear, and another little girl who was there as well. After they were done, they went back to their room. Jimmy's mom stayed with him as he fell asleep. The next morning when Jimmy woke up, it was time for surgery. His mom and Bear went down to the operating room together and waited for the nurse to come and get him. The nurse came and talked to Jimmy to let him know what was going to happen. Then she walked him into the room. She helped him onto the stretcher. Once he was on the stretcher, she asked, "Are you okay?" Jimmy said, "I'm being as brave as I can, just like my mom asked me to." "I know you are," said the nurse. "You're being very brave. Your mom and Bear will be here when you wake up." In the operating room, everyone who came in was wearing masks and gowns. "We're going to put a mask on your nose too," the doctor said, "and you'll go to sleep." Jimmy tried to tell them the mask smelled funny, but he mumbled the words and fell asleep quickly. The surgery to remove Jimmy's tonsils was done while he was asleep. He did not feel a thing. Everything was a bit blurry when he woke up and his throat was sore, but Bear, the nurse, and his mom were all there beside him. The nurse checked on Jimmy to make sure he was okay as he woke up. They even brought him a popsicle. He was hungry by this time. Everything had gone well, so Jimmy could go home. Jimmy said goodbye to the nurses. It had been a very scary time at the hospital, but everyone had been so friendly. His mom and Bear had been there most of the time. He had met a new friend, and now his tonsils wouldn't make him sick all of the time. So Jimmy, Bear, and his mom went home.